no matter what happens.
Yeah, I got something. This is how bad them chariots are, or how bad the power of the Lord is. This is Isaiah 4:3. And it shall come to pass that he that is left in Zion and he that remaineth in Jerusalem shall be called holy, even every one that is written among the living in Jerusalem, the elect. When the Lord shall have washed away the filth of the daughters of Zion, and shall have purged the blood of Jerusalem from the midst thereof by the spirit of judgment and by the spirit of burning, and the Lord will create upon every dwelling place of Mount Zion, and upon her assemblies, a cloud and smoke by day.
Right. So like here in this kingdom, you walk by houses, what do you see? Jeeps. You know, Lexus is in the kingdom. We gonna have a chariot, man, over our dwelling places, man. That's what that's talking about, man.
And the Lord will create upon every dwelling place of Mount Zion and upon her assemblies a cloud and smoke by day and shine in a flaming fire by night.
Right.
For upon all the glory shall be a defense.
Right. Yep. And that's gonna be the vibration of righteousness is gonna be just pushed out, man.
Yeah.
Every day.
Well, that's our fears. When the Lord comes, he's coming back with the clouds of heaven. That's them chariots.
Right.
So it's saying the kingdom is going to be a memorial.
Right.
When them chariots are so fast. And when we came out of Egypt, the Lord, it was Yahweh Shai in the chariot, a cloud by day and a flaming fire by night. So in the kingdom, they're going to be amongst all Jerusalem.
Man.
Just to let the heathen know, if you ever think about coming up against Israel again, that's your ass.
Right. Right.
That's right.
And when them chariots come, you got to remember, they could come in the size of a city. They could disappear. They could go in water without even making the damn water quiver.
Right.
Yep. That's power, man.
Yep.
That's power.
If I could say one thing, I seen a video, it was about 2 weeks ago. It was these fishermen. And they was video recording. One chariot was on this side, flew across the sky. There was another one closer to one underwater, was shot down in the water. So, I mean, they can disappear like you said, they can do anything.
Yeah. That glory when they come is bright. That light, that's how you know. There's nothing that Esau can't replicate that. They can't do nothing. Maybe close to that Hollywood magic they can try. But when the chariot's actually in that air, hey, your man, one of my co-workers, he called me and said, you see that light in the middle of the night? And this woman videotaped, it was a chariot. The way it moved and stopped, it moved, he bugged out to this day. That's power, man. Isaiah 66:15. Because Esau got his air force, he got his army. It's nothing compared to the Most High. Nothing, man.
Right.
And that's why when Yahweh Shai told Pontius Pilate, he said, look, I lay down my life. You don't take a damn thing. He said, I pray the Lord, what, give me 12 legions of angels? That was a heavy statement, he said, man. He said, if I call, but the Lord said, I lay down my life. So Israel, hell, that's why we know the things we know and doing his work and still living.
Right.
Because Yahweh Shai shed his blood, man. We let you know how powerful the Lord's army is, man.
That's right. I got it.
Got to bring it up.
This is Isaiah 66:15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire.
And that we were talking about the Roman Catholic Church showing that Esau is just a pedophile faggot.
Man.
They'll have little white clouds and little white naked angel, little boys, little babies. White little white naked babies. No, when the angels came, even when they spoke to the prophets, they dropped as forth the Most High was in their presence.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's how fierce the angels are.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, man.
So when the Lord come back, he said coming back with vengeance and coming back with them chariots.
Mm.
He's all gonna get annihilated. You know how you watch that movie Transformers? Years ago, Apostle Tar, he had a dream. I never forget, he came in, he said, man, I had a dream as bad as fuck. He said, man, he said, when the chariots came, they ain't just come like Esau got it, just standing in formation. They was coming up, tearing the foundations up. They were transforming on their ass. That's where they get it from. Remember, the Transformers came from outer space. Esau don't come up with nothing out of it.
Yeah.
Everything he steals. Everything from his plot, his dialogue, everything. Even that movie in Star Wars, that was all based off the Bible.
That's right.
He's a thief by nature. You got that? you, matter of fact, you more on that, right?
Okay. This is verse 16. For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh.
They show you there ain't no damn naked cracker babies with little wings on their back. That's a white man's old freak pedophile fantasy.
That's right.
Right.
When the angels come back, they come in fast.
Now, first of all, the angels are not Caucasian.
Hell no.
The angels, they come. They look like men of color. The angels are so-called black men.
That's right, yeah.
7 foot, 8 foot tall black men that occupy those chariots of what the white man calls UFOs, man.
I've seen them.
They've seen them astronauts.
Yeah.
There's a documentary on YouTube that we was watching, them astronauts, the stuff they saw when they was out there, but when they came back, of course, they debriefed them, and they told them, but years later, these dudes are coming out and tell them what they actually saw out there when it was in outer space.
Yeah, well, that's where you get that movie, Men in Black, with Will Smith.
Yeah.
And they come, and you know how they now see, most people look at that stuff, and they think it's all just a movie. And they use the red dot to hypnotize people. Yeah. There's been plenty of people when they had abductions. You had that one movie called Fire in the Sky, was it Travis Smith or whatever?
Travis Walton.
Travis Walton story. A lot of times when the people get abducted and they come back, the Men in Black come get them. And they hypnotize them, you know, make sure that they don't tell the right story. Because a lot of times, if they get under another hypnosis, they'll say that, look, the men we seen, they wasn't aliens. They had shiny, black, leathery skin. That's what the people would say. Now, that thing with the alien, that come from your man, Aleister Crowley. It was a demon that he used to talk to, Iwas, or Iwas. And that's what they put the image up. I watched with that big head and them eyes looking, or look like Spider-Man. And that's what the image that they'll have people constantly come over. So they're showing that they're using that demon Iwas to put that in their mind.
Yeah.
You remember the white man deals with witchcraft?
Well, Von L. Hubbard, the dude that started Scientology.
Yeah.
That's the demon he was praying for. Well, he was
Aleister Crowley's understudy.
Yeah, he was Aleister Crowley's understudy. Came with that Scientology doctrine.
That's right.
The same demon.
Yeah. Everything's entangled and put together. Now they come out through the Spirit of the Lord. Researching, reading. You know, that's right, tell brothers, man. You got new brothers coming in, young brothers. Leave them video games alone. Now listen to all that monkey rap music and read. You know, when you come onto this, you become a higher level, man. The Lord brings you up your mind on a higher level. The things you used to do, that's an old man. You're supposed to start getting away, purging every day.
That's right.
To come into this and pray for the Lord to give you more knowledge, wisdom, and understanding.
Yeah.
That's what the scripture tell you in James, the Lord upbraideth not. He ain't gonna get mad you ask for that. Now you asking for hoes and all that other bullshit, more money and all that. That's bullshit, man. That's being carnally minded. That's really carnally minded. That's the things to please the flesh. And when you get too comfortable and get too much pleasure, the scripture says she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. That's why you suffer when you come into this. Because when you suffer, your mind is at sharp.
Oh, that's true.
When you lose your job and you at rock bottom, you see who's really there for you.
That's right.
When your woman leave you, you see what a whore they are. When you come into this and you really get in trouble, you'll see whether your father, your mother, your brother, what they really into.
That's right, brother.
You'll see that most of the time they don't give a hell about you. They'll be the first one to administrate your little ass right to the white man. You got something?
Yeah. Colossians, the 3rd chapter, the first verse. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above.
Yeah, what's above? Learning your nationality, the name of the Most High. Seeing your people dwell in righteousness, ruling. Not sitting there shucking and jiving with a rap contract. To be in that world, you gotta be a homosexual.
Yeah.
That's where all that shit coming out with Young Thug and Baby Boy and Lil Weezy, Drake, his old feminine ass. Being today, they talking about, what's that damn song they got, man? I did a lot to live that lifestyle. What they did was bend over and spread their ass cheeks.
Yeah, can I say this? Because they pushing that on these young black and Latino men. The so-called white man wants to feminize the young so-called black and Latino men in this society. Just, hey, that's the spirit. Look at that. That's the spirit. See? That's the spirit. That's the spirit. But they're trying to feminize these young men in this society. Because if you could feminize all the men of a society and make them all of the homosexuals or lesbians, then that race can't reproduce. You understand? If everybody's homosexual, on this sign of all of our people turn to that, then how the hell can we reproduce as a race?
And they push that in the media.
And they're pushing
man.
That.
They push black men being a homosexual real hard, man. You know what I'm saying? Anytime you see a sitcom, the person is a black guy, man. Michael Sam, they hear him. You know what I'm saying? You have the one Puerto Rican boxer that came out, man. They pushing for you Negroes and Latinos and Native Americans to be homosexuals, man.
Yeah. Right. Look at it. Niggas wearing pink.
The white man.
Hey, we going on early 40s or whatever? Years ago, man, if a nigga walk by with some pink shoes, he get his ass whooped.
Right. Yeah.
Some tight pants. Them punk rockers, the white boys was doing that shit. Mohawks, tattoos.
Yeah, but now niggas are doing it.
Yeah, they didn't. That's the new punk rock.
Yeah.
Rap is the new punk rock. We seen it. We lived it. Man, if you coming in with some tight jeans, man, what the hell you been hanging around the white boys? Now the niggas embraced it, man. Wearing pink polos, pink button downs, wearing rainbow colored sneakers, man. Yeah. Wearing damn near earrings and shit in their nose.
They taking away gender.
Yeah.
It's basically no difference between male and female.
They want you to be androgynous
society.
Gender bending. What are you bending? Your fucking ass over, man.
That's right.
Basically, it's just too much, man. Too much.
That's right.
Reading on this. Says, where my Yahawashah sitteth on the right hand of the Most High. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth.
What's the things above? This knowledge. Like the Most High said, your ways aren't His ways. Our ways aren't His ways. When you're born in this world, the scriptures say the creature is subject unto vanity. You was born into this. When you're born in this world, it's flesh, you're wicked automatically, your mind.
That's
it,
right.
What dwells in the heart? Witchcraft, adulteries, sorceries. But then when you come to the law of the Most High, that guides you. And that's the way of the Most High. He's a separate. He's separate. He said, look, I ain't gonna make my servant equal to me. The Most High made it that way. It's a thing of order. So when you come onto this, or things setting your affection on things above, it's this knowledge.
That's right. Like, the scripture says that wisdom is too high for a fool. You know,
that's right.
So a fool is not gonna be able to set his mind on things above, man, things that are eternal. He's setting his mind on things that are tangible, carnal. Yeah. You know.
Riches right. are too common for a nigga.
Yep.
The scriptures.
Yeah.
Riches.
Yep.
That's what was I saying?
Romans 11:33.
Right.
Riches of the Most High, man.
Okay.
It's like it. And there's another thing too. When you come into this here, the Lord can sit there and make you get a whole bunch of muscle bound and make you this, but then you'll think you did it on your own.
Right.
That's why the Lord's looking for regular men. So He gets the glory, He gets the credit. He is the Most High, He's the ultimate Judah. He loved the praise.
Right.
Rightfully so. He's a bad man.
So great, man.
Yeah.
Because you know, you can't do nothing without the Most High. Without the Creator, you can't breathe the next couple of seconds, man. The Most High can take the breath out of your body. So He should get the prayer, but we ain't got no power.
No.
If we could, then we could get ourselves out of this condition.
That's right. And we've been trying that, and our people have been trying all these different ways to get out of this condition and have failed because they won't recognize their power. Yeah. They won't come back to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh, man. That's why that black consciousness movement didn't work.
Nope.
Your whole Muslim movement didn't work. You know?
Black Panthers.
The Black Panthers didn't work, man.
The Black Liberation Army.
Yeah.
Brown Berets.
I'm gonna say something. I'm gonna show you about something spiritual. That Edomite, that white man that was up there, that's an Edomite. Now the puppies were here, the dogs are here, the brother been standing here for a while. The dogs ain't barking at nobody up here, they just chilling. As soon as that Edomite came up, the dogs started barking at him.
Yeah.
Now, why is that?
Dogs are spiritual, man.
All animals are spiritual.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
But like I said, they've been chilling. They're here looking, they just chilling. But when the Edomite came walking up behind, the puppy looked at and started barking at the devil. Mm-hmm. Because they are the devil. They had an off spirit. Yeah, and even the animals know that.
Yeah.
Even the animals could recognize. But tell me, I mean, you know, you saw it yourself. They didn't bark at nobody up here until that white boy came and the dog started barking at
him. Yeah. Well, them
you saw that, right?
Can't wait to get a hold of the so-called white man. Anytime these animals have an opportunity to jack up one of these so-called white people, they take advantage of it.
In New York City, you have the horse-drawn carriages. First of all, look, I'm going to explain something to you. We're not supposed to be walking on concrete. That's why you got back problems, foot problems. You're not supposed to walk on concrete. You're supposed to walk on the earth, man, on the soil. Because the Most High put energies and things in the soil, and you're supposed to be one with the earth. The earth has a spirit, and you're supposed to vibe.